When we want to import model data in different local currencies, we need to ensure that our models are saved with currency conversion enabled. In this case, our model has the default currency set to USD, and the maximum number of currency conversions that can be displayed simultaneously in tables based on the model is set to 4. In the dimension that contains the model's currency information, all the regions also have USD as the local currency, apart from overseas. Its subregions, EMEA and Asia Pacific, use the euro and the yuan respectively. In a table based on the model, initially, all of the values display in the model's default currency of USD. To display additional currencies, we first need to add the cross-calculations dimension to the table. A cross-calculations column is added, which indicates that all values are converted to the model's default currency. To add rows that display values in each region's local currency, we need to modify the filter for the cross-calculation dimension and add the currency member. Additional rows are added to display the local currency value for each region. Note that the EMEA and Asia Pacific values display in euros and yuan, respectively, as configured in the model. Also note that several of the local currency rows display no values. This is because the members of the hierarchy don't share the same local currency, and no currency conversion is taking place. We see only the amount that was originally imported for each leaf member. We can add rows to display values in other currencies by adding currency conversion calculations to the cross-calculations dimension. In this case, we'll add a cross-calculation to display values in euros. First, we'll enter a name for the currency conversion calculation. Next, we need to specify the currency. Note that the currencies we can choose from are those that are available in the model's currency conversion table. In the category area, we can specify a rate category from the currency conversion table if desired, or choose dynamic to automatically use the rate category that's currently specified for each category in the model. We can also specify a rate version if named rate versions are available in the conversion table for the currency we've specified. Note that we need to choose specific in the category area before we can choose a rate version. In the date area, we can use the booking date, set a booking date of plus or minus a year, quarter, or month, or set a fixed date. In this case, we'll use the booking date. This means that currency conversion rates will be used based on each record's transaction date. Rows are added to display the values in euros. Note that because these rows are based on a currency conversion calculation, there are no empty cells. Values imported in any currency are converted into euros. We've added several additional currency conversion cross-calculations to the table. Note that when the number of currency conversions available exceeds the maximum value we set in the model, which in this case was 4, a Select Conversions option displays. We need to remove one of the 4 currency conversions that is currently selected before we can choose an additional currency. Thanks for watching.